Growing up, you have certain amount of pride, certain amount of dignity, certain amount of how you look at yourself and your family. And as a man of God, you serve God, you go to church. And my son, one son. And I went to Malton or Milton, and when I go through whatever they have to carry you through when your son is locked up. And I sat there and looked at the young man. God, where have I failed the father? Where have I went wrong? Another time, it wasn't gun violence, but was violent act. Another time I go to Finch and Larry's or somewhere or whatever courthouse to beg the young man out, and the first thing he never said, "Dad, thank you. Mom, you think you're the only one that bear burden and can't go through stuff. We don't talk as men. What we go through, now we feel it." You never say thank you. You just ask us to stop at McDonald's. Dad, could you please stop at McDonald's? I stopped. And maybe Mama, a Big Mac. I didn't have a Big Mac. One Sunday morning, we're at church again, and it was in my custody, as it has been said. I just asked him to go. We were doing something at church again, and asked him to just go pick up something, and he was stopped again by the police. And by the time I got around and got the message and jumped in my car and got it because he was driving it. And by the time I go to the police station, it was too late, and so they had to lock him down again. And before I go to church Sunday morning, I had to go again to get him out or bail him out, whatever it was. I'm not too sure it happened that Sunday morning, so I had to go back again in a week. So the struggle, the pain, the hurt, the disappointment, the discouragement, the trauma that take place in our coming in our lives.